operating the machine. When you arrive on site, always do a site assessment first. Look around for any conditions or obstructions that could hinder trenching or make operating the machine unsafe for anyone. If there's a source of sparks, flames, or unknown vapors nearby, do not operate. When your assessment is complete, lock the trencher's wheel hubs and start it up. For starting in cold weather conditions, consult your owner's manual. Engage the wheel drive lever. Push it up to move forward. Pull it back to move the trencher in reverse. Always travel slowly, especially if you're inexperienced. Position the trencher. Keep in mind that the trencher is designed to trench while moving in reverse. Avoid driving near drop-offs or embankments. Also, avoid driving or operating the trencher on a slope. You can drive and trench on up to a 20-degree slope. However, if the trencher is driven or parked on a slope of greater than 20 degrees, the machine will shut down automatically. Also, never drive too close to the side of a previous trench. The weight of the trencher could collapse the trench wall, flipping the machine. Once you're positioned and are ready to begin, put the wheel drive control in neutral. Stop and engage both wheel hubs if either was unlocked. Put the engine in full throttle. Hold the dig chain engage lever in the on position. Squeeze the clutch lever. Slowly lower the boom until the chain is at your desired depth. Put the wheel drive control in reverse and slowly start to trench. Adjust your speed to the soil conditions and terrain until you've got it right. If at any point rocks, roots, or other objects jam the chain, release the clutch lever, then reverse the chain to dislodge the debris. If the wheels have poor traction, the trencher may tilt back a bit when it starts to trench, pulling it toward the operator. If it does this, release the pressure and allow the trencher weight to plunge into the ground. However, be careful. Never plunge faster than the trencher can remove material from the ground. Never overload the engine. If the engine lugs down or the digging chain slows, release the wheel drive control until the engine speed recovers, then continue trenching. After the job, once trenching is complete, move the trencher to level ground and park. Lower the boom onto the ground. Ensure that the dig chain engage lever is in neutral when you've parked. Reduce the throttle to idle. Close the fuel shutoff valve. If you don't, fuel could leak into the cylinder and crankcase. Damage from this is not covered under warranty. Let the machine cool entirely before performing maintenance, cleaning, or touching the engine, muffler, hydraulic lines, or hydraulic fluid. To clean the machine, wait until it's cool and then spray it down with water. Once you return to the shop, complete all other required cleaning, lubrication, and battery maintenance. Also, complete any required cleaning and maintenance on your Barreto 4x6 tilt bed trailer. For specifics on these tasks, consult your owner's manual. For more information, visit www.barettomfg.com.